Students and welcome to today's session about the business analytics, in which we will start with the unit 5 lecture number 27, that is decision analysis. So decision analysis of decision, that is if either yes or no, that is called decision analysis. We will see what is decision analysis, what is the decision making process, and what are the criteria for decision making. So this is the overview of decision analysis. So outline of today's lecture, that is decision analysis, what is decision analysis, what is the decision making, how decision making can be done, criteria for decision making, what are the criteria for decision making. There are mainly two criteria: under risk, decision making under risk, and decision making under uncertainty. Decision making model means we will see decision making steps. What are the steps for decision making? So what is decision analysis? The field of decision analysis provide a framework. So decision analysis is a field which provide the framework for making many type of important decisions. So if we take the example of raining, whether it will rain tomorrow or not, that is we will take the decision on that. So decision analysis allow us to select a decision from the set of possible decision alternatives. So decision analysis, we can in that we can select different types of decision from the different set of possible alternatives. What are the alternatives for that? And from that alternatives we will select one decision when uncertainties regarding the future exist. What are the uncertainties for the future in business analytics? So decision plays important role in business analytics. The goal is to optimize the resulting payoffs. What are the main goal of decision making or analysis? Is to make the optimization. We have to optimize the results of the in the terms of decision criteria. So we have to minimize the criteria in the decision basis in decision analysis. Now we will see what is decision making. A decision making is a mental process. It is one type of process resulting in selection of an alternative way. So we can select alternative way in mental process among the different alternatives. So in every field we have to take the decision. And decision making also play important role in business analytics. In simple words, we can say decision making is a process in which we select an best alternative from a set of alternative. So decision making is a one type of process. There is a set of alternatives and we have to select the best solution from that alternative. That is called decision making. So this is the definition of decision making. Every decision making process produces a final choice. So each decision will make a what is the final choice for that project or the analysis. So this is a question which can be asked in YouTube. What is decision making in 1 mark question? After that, uncertainty and risk in decision making. How uncertainty and risk play in decision making? So decision can be short term to intermediate as well as long term. So decision can be of three types: short term decisions, long term decisions, and intermediate decisions. We also know that decisions are made up for future. So we have to make the decisions on our future base, and future is the uncertainty condition. So uncertainty variable comes into picture in decision making for the future analysis. Many decision tools have been developed to solve the uncertainty in decision. So we have developed many decision tools for solving the uncertainty, how we can solve the uncertainties in decision making. So there are different tools like diagram we have to produce for the decision making. So these are the tools, or we can say decision analysis is one of the tool for solving the uncertainty in decisions. These tools forms an important component called decision analysis. So this plays an important role for playing the important role in the decision, which is called as decision analysis. Normally in decision we have two or more alternatives. So in normal decision we are making one or two or more alternatives will be taken, for and after that we have to select one alternative from that is called decision making. The consequence of the alternative depends upon the outcome. So there are different consequences which will be occur in the decision making, and the outcomes play important role for the future of random event. If there are different types of event like weather forecasting system or the stock market stock market prediction, where we can the future events will be occur and different outcomes will be produced. So we have to select alternative part from that uncertainty condition in decision making. So different factors will play for making the alternatives in decision making. Outcomes of such decisions are usually unexpected. So result what will be come or outcomes will be come from the decisions that are unexpected results. We cannot change that results and results that are unexpected from these outcomes, but possible to predict by information. So we can predict the result, what will be the future result, by taking the past data in weather forecasting, and then we can check and we can predict the future result, and after that we will select one alternative way in decision making. Now we will see the various criteria for decision making. If a decision maker carry out information about an alternative, upon it become easy to take decision. So decision maker will take the information from the decisions. He or she can take the decisions from the information for this any type of project or the business in the business analytics, and came to an alternative way. He can select one best optimal way for making the decision easily. So we can make the decision easily by following these criteria. Second criteria is that, like converting available information into measure of desirability. So we can take the information and we can convert it into the measure of desirable. What are the output desirable results are there, and how we can take the accuracy, we can check the accuracy of that result by following these criteria in decision making. Another appropriate criteria for decision making is probability estimation of future outcomes. So we will estimate the future outcomes. Suppose there is an example of weather forecasting system, so we will check the probability, what is the probability of that for calculating the whether it will rain tomorrow or not for the future outcome. So this is the one criteria for making the decision. Another criteria is to decision maker to take the risk. So decision maker will take risk for the analysis of the decision, whether it will rain tomorrow or not, or it will predict on the basis of the past data. So decision making plays important role in the various applications of business analytics. Decision making under uncertainty. The decision when we are made in situation in which simple decision maker know that could occur. So decision maker will make the simple decision, what are the situation for it, and we can take easily for the uncertainty, but have no idea for probability. So uncertainty, in that decision maker has no idea for probability, how probability can occur for each outcome occurring, what is the outcome of the probability, that decision maker should not have the idea for it in the uncertainty condition. Decisions that are made under above described situation are called decision making under uncertainty. So decisions which are taken under above description are called it decision making under uncertainty. So this is the definition of decision making under uncertainty. Now we will see the criteria for decision under uncertainty. So first criteria is maximum. Determine the best possible payoff. What is the best possible outcome or result from each alternative? There are different ways of making the decision, and we have to select one possible way from that so that we can easily make the decision. So this is the maximum way. So this is the first criteria for decision under uncertainty. Second criteria is maximum. Determine the worst possible way. So what is the worst case that we have to select from the different ways for selecting the decision. There are different set of decisions, and we have to select the worst case from that, and we have to check the decision under the uncertainty variable. Then select by looking to worst case that can occur. What is the worst case occur in that situation? And we have to select and try to minimize. We have to minimize the risk or the bad result from that in the uncertainty condition. Next criteria is LAPES. So select the alternative that has an average payoff. So we have to select the alternative way or the alternative decisions which gives the average result for the uncertainty condition in decision making. This criteria treats all features feature outcomes as being equally. So it is most important criteria for feature outcome in equality. Next is minimax regret. Commutate the regret for each payoffs. We have to calculate the regret for each payoffs for the result which is difference that payoffs and the payoffs that could have occur. What are the payoffs occur or the outcomes occur in the probability? We have to select, and after that we have to select the best alternative path for the regretting the minimum maximum criteria. So this is the important criteria for decision making under uncertainty. Then select the alternative way. So after selecting the best way, then we select the what is the other alternative way for carrying the smallest regret value, so that we can minimize the regret value after calculating the decision under uncertainty. Next topic is about the decision making and the risk. When the decision maker have the probability, so decision maker will check the probability, what are the future probability value will be estimated for the events occurring. What are the events occur, like weather forecasting system, it will take the past data and then it will check the probability that whether it will rain tomorrow or not, what are the storm value for that. So it will take the decision on that. Then this decision under such situation are known as decision making under risk. So if we take under such situation future calculate the probability, then that is called decision making at risk. Then what are the criteria for decision under the risk? Decision criteria for such situation are uses of information. What type of information we are using and what are the decision making is done for an alternative way in the decision making. Then selecting that alternative way on the basis of information carried by alternative. So we have to select alternative path from the set of best alternative path. We have to select one alternative path on the basis of information. So weather information system is there, so we have to carry all information regarding the weather, and then we have to select the best alternative path for that decision. Now the decision making process, or we say decision making model. So there are mainly 5 steps for decision making process which will be shown in figure. First step is identify the problem. What type of problem we have to identify, that is scanning of images or diagnosis of area in the decision making. So it is the most important step, that is the first step in decision making. After identifying the problems, we will identify the resources. What are the resources available, like people, material, persons, etc. So these are the resources we have to identify. After identifying the resources, we have to formulate the problem. What is the problem for the model? What are the problems? What are the payoffs for that? What are the outcomes or probability of the result are there? And after formulating the problems, we have to implement the model. Means for formulating the problem, we have to generate the alternative way. What are the alternative way, like brainstorming is the most important way. And after implementing the formulating problem, we will implement the model. We have to implement the result of that model. And after implementing the result, we will analyze the model. Means we will analyze the decision making process. What are the result for that? We have to analyze in the using the graph. We have to plot that graph, simulation result in Monte Carlo simulation. We have to plot that graph, and after analysis of the result will be done, testing the result. We have to check the result, whether it result is making in decision making process is proper or not. After we have to check the testing, we will implement that solution. So we have to implement finally that solution, and after implementation we have to again monitor that solution. We have to check the result, what are the result of that solution, and if it gives the unsatisfactory result, then again it goes to the formulation of problem, and after that implement the model. We have to implement that decision making model. So these are the, this is the whole step which is shown in the figure of decision making process. First step is identifying the problem, then formulating the problem and implement the model. After that we will analyze the model, and after that test the result, and after testing we will implement that solution, and after implementing that solution we will monitor this solution. So this is how the decision making process done. So this is about today's lecture, that is overview of decision analysis. Thank you student, stay tuned for further lecture series. In next lecture we will see the formulation of problem, decision problems in detail. After that we will see about the decision tree, what are the decision tree in detail. After that decision strategies, what are the decision strategies with and without outcomes and utility in decision.